Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at how we go about finding probability from ratios. So for this first question, we have that in a bag there are only red counters, blue counters and green counters. The ratio of the number of red counters to the number of blue counters to the number of green counters is in the ratio 3:4:5. A counter is taken at random from the bag. We need to complete the table to show the probabilities of the counter being red, blue or green. So to begin with, we can start by looking at the parts of our ratio. We've got the red parts, blue and green, and they're in the ratio of 3:4:5. So we have 3 parts for red, 4 parts for blue and 5 parts for green. We can also now figure out the total parts. And all we have to do here is simply add the individual parts together. So if we do 3, add 4, that's going to give us 7. Add on the 5, that'll give us 12. So now we can find our 3 different probabilities, all as fractions. So for the probability of the counter being red, all I'm going to do is take the parts for red and put that over the total amount of parts. So for red, we know we've got 3 parts, and that's out of a total of 12 possible parts. So our fraction here would actually be 3/12. But we can simplify this fraction. We can divide the numerator and denominator both by 3. And if we do that, that's going to give us 1/4. So our probability of picking a red counter would be 1/4. Now for the probability of the counter being blue, well, we know that there are 4 parts for blue. And we're going to put that over the total amount of parts, which was 12. So our probability here would be 4/12. But we can also simplify this. We can divide top and bottom both by 4, and if we do that, that's going to give us 1/3. So our probability of picking a blue counter would be 1/3. And then finally, our probability of picking the green counter. Well, we know there were 5 parts for green out of the total possible 12 parts. So the probability of green would be 5/12. We can't simplify that any further. So in the table, all we're going to do for green is put 5/12. So our probabilities of red, blue and green would be 1/4, 1/3 and 5/12. So for this next question, we have that a biased spinner can land on red, blue, green or yellow. The table shows the probabilities that the spinner will land on red and green. The probability that the spinner will land on blue is twice the probability that the spinner will land on yellow. We need to complete the table of probabilities. So this time we've been given our probabilities as a decimal, so we're going to figure out the remaining probabilities as a decimal too. So for our ratio part in this question, we can see that we had that the probability that the spinner will land on blue is twice the probability that the spinner will land on yellow. So we can write this as a ratio, blue to yellow. Well, if the spinner is twice as likely to land on blue than yellow, we can write this as a ratio in its simplest form as 2:1. So we've got 2 parts for blue and 1 part for yellow. And again, we can also figure out our total parts, which may be useful. And all we need to do here is add our individual parts. So 2 for blue, add the 1 for yellow, is going to give us 3 total parts. So now what we need to do is link one of these parts back into the question. So we've got 2 parts for blue, 1 part for yellow, and the combination by adding both of these gives us a total part of 3. So from the question, we can actually figure out the remaining probability. We know that the probability of the spinner landing on red is 0.37, and the probability of the spinner landing on green is 0.24. So we can start by adding those 2 probabilities together. Well, if we do 0.37, add on this 0.24, well, that's going to give us 0.61. So all probabilities must always add up to 1. So if so far our probabilities add up to 0.61, to figure out what's remaining, all we're now going to do is 1, take away what we've already got, which is this 0.61, and that's going to leave us with 0.39. So we now want to link that 0.39 back to one of the parts. But we know it's not the parts for blue, it's not the parts for yellow, it's the combination of them both. So we can link this back to the total parts. We know that 3 parts is going to give us a probability of 0.39. So now that we've made that connection, we've linked the parts to the probability, we can now figure out what each individual part is. So what we're doing here is dividing the left-hand side by 3. So 3 divided by 3 gives us 1. So we're going to do the same to the right-hand side. We're going to do 0.39 divided by 3. And that's going to give us 0.13. So going back to the ratio, for the parts for yellow, we had one part. So we know that one part is equivalent to 0.13. So the probability for yellow is going to be 0.13. And then for blue, we have two parts. So to figure out the probability for two parts, we're just simply going to multiply that one part by 2. So we're going to do the same to the 0.13. And when we times that by 2, we get 0.26. So our probability for blue is 0.26. So now looking at the table of probabilities, all of those probabilities add up to 1. And we can see that the probability that the spinner will land on blue is twice the probability that the spinner will land on yellow. Okay, and for our final question, we have that a bias spinner can land on red, blue, green, or yellow. The table shows the probabilities that the spinner will land on red and blue. The probability of green to the probability of yellow is in the ratio of 2 to 3. We need to complete the table of probabilities. So we can start by rewriting this probability of green to yellow, which we're told in the question is in the ratio of 2 to 3. So we've got our individual parts here. Again, we can also find our total parts. And we'd simply do that by adding the individual parts together. So 2 add 3 gives us 5. So we have 2 parts for green, 3 parts for Y, which gives us a total parts of 5. So now we want to see what we can figure out from the question. So we've been given the probabilities of red and blue. So again, we can figure out the probabilities that are left over because all of our probabilities should add up to 1. So let's add the probabilities that we've been given. Well, we have 0.15 for red. And we're going to add the 0.4 for blue. So we've got our 0.4. To make it easier, we can write that to 2 decimal places. We can stick a 0 in there. So 0.15 add 0.40. That's going to give us 0.55. So that's the probabilities that we've got so far. So then to figure out what's left over, we're just going to do 1 take away this 0.55, and that's going to leave us with 0.45. So now this 0.45, we want to link back to the parts. Well, that 0.45 doesn't represent the parts for green, and it doesn't represent the parts for yellow. That's going to represent the total parts, because it's the probabilities of the combination of green and yellow. So we can now say that 5 parts is equivalent to our probability of 0.45. So we've made that connection between the parts and probability. So just like before, all we're going to do now is find what each individual part is worth. So to get from 5 to 1, we're just simply going to divide the left-hand side by 5. So to keep things equivalent, we're going to do exactly the same to the right-hand side. So if we do 0.45 divided by 5, that's going to give us 0.09. So now to find our probabilities, well, for the green, looking at the ratio, we can see that that's 2 parts. So we can do 2 multiplied by whatever this one part was. Well, one part was 0.09. So if we do 2 multiplied by 0.09, that's going to give us 0.18. So that's our probability for green. We can write that in the table. And then for our probability of yellow, looking back at the ratio, we can see that yellow had 3 parts. So we can do 3 multiplied by what one part was worth. Again, one part was 0.09. And if we do 3 multiplied by 0.09, that's going to give us 0.27. So we can write this in the table. Our probability for yellow is 0.27. So our table's complete. All of our probabilities add up to 1. And we can see that the probability of green to the probability of yellow is in the ratio of 2 to 3. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.